This is a demonstration of how to use the Rapid Response Multidrug Test Panel. Note, humidity and temperature can affect results. Do not use the test after the expiration date indicated on the package. Do not use the test if the pouch is damaged. How to use the Rapid Response Multidrug Test Panel. The test panel and controls should be brought to room temperature prior to testing. Do not open the pouch until you are ready to perform the test. Your kit will contain test panels in individually sealed pouches and a product insert. Materials required but not provided: a timer, specimen collection container, external positive and negative controls. Read the instructions carefully before you begin. The urine specimen should be collected using a clean and dry container. When you are prepared to use the test, open the pouch. Remove the test panel from its sealed pouch and use it as soon as possible. The Rapid Response Multidrug Test Panel simultaneously detects for three commonly used illicit drugs: xylazine, fentanyl, and nitazene. Write the donor's name or ID on the panel in the provided space. Remove the cap. With the arrows pointing toward the urine specimen, immerse the sample tips vertically in the specimen for at least 20 seconds. Do not dip past the max line. After 20 seconds, replace the cap back onto the panel and place the panel on a clean level surface. Start a 5-minute timer. Read the test results at 5 minutes. Do not interpret results after 10 minutes. Interpretation of the results. Positive results. One colored line appears in the control region. No line appears in the test region. This positive result indicates that the drug concentration is above the detectable level. Negative results. Two lines appear. One colored line should be in the control region, and another apparent colored line should be in the test region. This negative result indicates that the drug concentration is below the detectable level. Note: the shade of color in the test line region will vary, but it should be considered negative whenever there is even a faint line. Invalid results. Control line fails to appear. Review the procedure and repeat using a new test. If the problem persists, discontinue using the lot immediately and contact the manufacturer. Note: insufficient specimen volume or incorrect procedural techniques are the most likely reasons for control line failure. After completing the test, dispose of all used test materials in the trash.